Okay, so I'll try to show you in this video a few of the main ideas of my article, how to make a search results page on an e-commerce website. So let's say you have this search and you have a search box and you have a way of presenting results. And this blog post is how to improve on this page. So the first thing I would suggest is use breadcrumbs for categories. So if someone types laptop 8 gigabytes on Amazon, and a good thing to do in that case is just showing things like this. These are related searches, and I would mostly refer to breadcrumbs on things such as this. So if I click on this on laptops, you will just send me to laptops category. You could also send me to laptops category and also filter it by memory. It doesn't have an option here, perhaps, I don't know. No. So, but perhaps if I would Google laptop 8 gigabyte, if I would search on your website laptop 8 gigabyte, you would just show me a link. Okay, if I would click this, show me a list of laptops with 8 gigabyte. So this is what I mean with breadcrumbs for categories. I would prefer having a link such as this for my query. So a link with just laptops and a link with laptops with 8 gigabytes. And what I mean is this, just send me to that category and with a filter. And I would appreciate it. Also, some options for filtering. So if I search this, I would prefer to have some things which Amazon does very well. So options to filter. Okay, you have this huge list of links. How do you filter? And you have lots of options for filtering. Okay, using synonyms. So on Amazon, if you type Intel CPU or Intel processor, you get processors and CPUs. It's not the same page, it's not the same result, but so even if I type CPU, I still get processor. So they're similar, you know, it's not identical, but similar. But if I type Intel microprocessor, they show me a lot of books and some products from time to time, but generally they don't know very well, they don't seem to know very well that microprocessor is pretty much the same thing. And I think that's pretty much a shame. So a shame. So if I were them, I would look into aggregating things. So Google has done this with some algorithms that. So if I would just go on Google to search for things like this, this is the first page of results for Intel CPU. For Intel processor and for Intel microprocessor. It's not the same, it's not identical, but it's not too much different, you know? It's different, but not too much. So Google is actually better at this kind of stuff. And they have an algorithm dedicated to this. And I think you should learn from them because I think it's a good idea. It's a bit complicated because I just gave you three examples, but imagine just having plural or singular, and perhaps some, instead of CPU, central, I don't know, CPU comes from something. Instead of CPU, you should know the acronym, which is Central Processing Unit. And I don't know, there are lots of synonyms, but perhaps just the most important ones, you could focus on them. Okay, and try to aggregate, to unite things. So if I type for Intel CPU, Intel processor, and Intel microprocessor, I should get pretty much the same page of results, and you should work on things like that. And allow room for typos. So I will have later on a section dedicated to just Google just for typos. So I will have a section just for typos on Apple.com, Amazon.com, and other websites. And I will look for this. And in there, Amazon will do good, but. As you will find in here, that if I type on Amazon Intel with double L, So just Intel with double L doesn't seem so much to know what I'm referring to. If I type it, let's start, try it like this. So this it knows. So probably it doesn't have too many results for Intel. But for Intel, perhaps it has, you know? So let's type Intel. So even Intel, it doesn't have too many results. But Intel with two L's, it has. So it shows just those results. If I go on Google and type Intel, Google show me this box. So even if I typed Intel wrongly, the second result is Intel.com. And the fourth result is also very relevant. And this, so Google knows much better than Amazon that Intel is pretty much Intel Corporation. Okay. There are ways to play with it, and I show it in the article how to play with Intel. You could, for example, if you can have an I, and on the keyboard the N next to M, so perhaps Intel, or perhaps sorry, instead of typing Intel, you forget one letter and you just type Intel, and now even Google is doesn't know what I'm referring to. But you know, to play with things like that, so missing words, typing another letter, and I don't know, just play with this. But only show them, I'm writing this only when you have no results. So if I type this word, I don't know, perhaps just this. Okay, so show me an alternative. Okay, we have nothing for what you wrote, but we show you alternative results. So I think you should be doing similar thing. The most relevant way to filter a page of results is by relevance. This is the most important criteria. And you should know what's relevant for the user and which is not. So even if you have a laptop of 8 gigabyte which is has more sales than others, perhaps you have a laptop which has more views and or is more searched or is more relevant in the past 24 hours, or I don't know. So you should focus on having this, the relevance thing, as the top criteria. And it's up to you to find what's relevant for the user and what isn't. Yes, you should also have this, like most popular or most sales or prices or even alphabetically or reviews, I don't know. But the most important thing is relevance. I think it's best to learn from searches. So if I type Sony Vaio and you see me clicking on this result, you should be learning from this. And next time, instead of putting my result, I don't know, fifth or sixth or this one, I think it's this, and the third row, you should put it higher. And if you still see that people click on it, put it even higher. And if people click on it, keep it there. But if people start clicking on this result, put this one higher, and so on. And continuously play until you... So there is no ending, because some products' popularity fades with time and new things appear. But you should constantly be learning, and it would be great if you could do it automatically. If you see that people who are searching for Sony Vaio click on this result, put more emphasis on placing that result higher. Also, put more information on the results page. So, if I go to Apple and search for iPhone, they show me this. And this is good. This is nice. I like it. I like this about Apple. You know, these are some results and they show me this. I don't like the way this box is made. I don't like the fact that the product is very small. There are a lot of things which I don't like. But the main idea that I search for iPhone and you show me two important products and this which is not relevant, but I will talk about this later. But anyhow, you show me what's most important first. This I like. And if I go to Google and type iPhone. No, let's type Apple. Look, they show me this box. So they are 100% sure that I mean Apple Inc., even if there are products for Apple. But they show me, look, Apple, look, the huge description, lots of links, this and news. And so a lot of emphasis on the company. Okay, if you want the product, okay, we'll have you an alternative. But first, a huge big box with the Apple. So this is what you should do. If I'm going to Amazon, and let's say I take this URL and this product and search for it, this product should probably be bigger than the other. Okay, you have other products which are related, I don't know. But show me this product with a big font. You know? This is what I searched for. If I search for Sony Vaio laptops, this is the most important... So you should just... Right now, you should just show me a link to a category which is Sony, which is laptops on your website, and filter just for Sony Vaio. So if I go Sony EMAG, I will show you a Romanian brand who does it. No. Let's go to this. So laptops, only Sony. This is what I want to see. And if I would just go Sony laptops, they don't do it. They in here, what I should have received is a link to this thing. List of laptops, Sony producer. This is exactly what I should have received. And a link to this. This is the most important link on the page to me. Okay, you should know how to differentiate. So if I write SSD laptop, it could either be the SSD in a laptop, so laptop, SSD, which are hard drives for laptops, or sort of hard drive for laptops, but it could also be laptops which have SSDs. And this in this case, both are relevant, and you should find a solution for both of them to be displayed. So if I type SSD laptop, show me SSDs for laptops, but show me also laptops with SSDs. Both are relevant. You should also learn from my searches. If I just type SSDs and looked a lot on SSD, then look SSD laptop, then probably I'm looking for SSDs which are meant for laptops. Okay, Amazon does this very good. So if I go in here and type laptop, they show me related searches. So laptop computer, laptop HP, tablet, I don't know. They help me to search better. Search filters. Look. What I mean with searching filter is this. So if I type laptop 8 GB, what Amazon shows me as a query, I would prefer to directly have a link to this. So I would prefer to have a link in here to would show me all the laptops with 8 GB of RAM and i7 processor. I would prefer to have it as a link. This is what I mean with searching filters. Try to match my query. So if I type in Google laptop 4 GB, Amazon know that I'm referring to RAM. If I write 256 GB, he knows I'm referring to SSD. If I type 1 TB, he knows I'm referring to hard drive. He ain't sure, so it's just an option. It's not mandatory. Perhaps I'm referring to an external hard drive, laptop with an, I don't know, laptop with a hybrid drive, perhaps. That's, yeah, hybrid. So perhaps if I wrote this, I'm searching for a hybrid drive for laptop. I don't know. So look, this actually fits my query. So you can't 100% know for sure. Perhaps I'm just looking for this. So this is a good query for this. But you should try and think what I would search for. And for this, you need to, from time to time, to manually look at searches. On Google Analytics, you have an option to analyze to show you statistics, to gather statistics of data by searches. Use it. You should implement it in Google Analytics to set it to monitor searches on your website, internal searches. And after you've done this, you should do some analytics analysis and look at what people have been searching on your website. Finally, start with the most important things. Grab the low-hanging fruits. So if you're Amazon, and if I type Sony laptops, you should find first a solution to give me something which is good in here. So they show me just Sony laptops? No, they show me this. And this is not relevant. If I look for Sony laptops, the first page I think should only be Sony laptops. This perhaps has links. I don't think that this is a relevant result for Sony laptops for the first page. Perhaps somewhere else, on filters, perhaps somewhere else, but not for my search. Let's go to Google and type Sony laptops. I think mostly in here you will find that there are laptops rather than other things. So let's take this product. So is it first? There are stores in which you can even search for the product ID and it's still not first. So this is low-hanging fruit. If I search for product ID, if I search for this, you should only show me the first product. And do it as Google does. Show me this big logo. Show me the product higher. Show me, give me more for the first product if you know exactly. So if I'm looking for Apple companies worldwide, Google doesn't know exactly what I'm referring to. Perhaps it's Apple, I don't know, he's not sure. Perhaps it's Apple, but he's not 100% sure. But if I search for Apple, he's sure that I'm looking for Apple. So if there are queries for which you are more certain that that your user is searching for exactly what you think is searching, so even in here, perhaps Google, okay, I think you are searching for this, but he's not sure. But in this case, he's sure. And so if it's sure, he shows you more prominently. Do this also. So if I search for product ID, product name, seller, if I search for Sony, I should pretty much see things which are related to Sony. And it does. All the products are Sony related. And this is what you should do. If I would go and have a look at other website, I would probably find, if I would go find Sony and find all sorts of things. No, you should first make sure that if I search for Sony on your website, or any brand that you have, you should only pretty much list me the products which you have in there. Okay, so these are my tips on improving the search results on e-commerce store. Good luck.